What we're trying to do is understand regulation of bacterial metabolism. At its highest level, that's what it's all about, right? And we want to do this from a systems levels perspective. What that means is that we are not trying to understand just how a single enzyme is regulated. We're trying to understand how complete pathways are regulated. And that's critical for many different reasons, especially for biofuel production and other processes. The main approach that we use in the lab is metabolomic approaches, which is basically a combination of high-resolution mass spectrometry and isotopic tracers to investigate cellular metabolism. And a lot of what we do, we apply to organisms that have not been applied to before. The organisms that we are actually going to be useful for biofuel production are not going to be model organisms. It's not going to be E. coli. It's going to be some other less known organisms that have much better properties for biofuel production. Cymomonas mobilis is a really good example of that. It's an organism that has an incredibly fast sugar catabolism. So of all of the microbes I have ever seen, is the microbe that is the fastest as converting glucose into ethanol. So whatever we can learn about metabolism bacteria can be applied to any other system, including humans. Because in principle, you know, as I said, when you eat a cheeseburger, you are essentially using the same metabolic pathways that the bacteria is using. They're not that different. You know, the glycolytic pathway, for example, is essentially identical in E. coli and in human cells.